Hello to all my BP TV fans, YouTube fans, and new fans to my fifth edition of Speedy Gourmet. I'm Al Levine, the talking machine, and I'm going to cook a meal for you today. Let me get my fish. It won't be a surprise anymore. Here we go. Mahi Mahi tells you all these good things about its wild caught. It was frozen. I let it thaw out overnight, and I'll be cutting it open right now. I'm going to walk towards the sink. For all of you that have watched, I get my Cutco knife out that I got years ago from my niece. I do cut it my own way to show you how simple it is. I cut right in one cut. Then I get another cut around, and we'll cut this real quick, or pretty quick, and I rinse it off. Here's the Mahi Mahi. It's a white fish. It's also known as a dolphin fish. It's not really a dolphin, but a dolphin fish, and it's a nice white fish, light flavor, sort of sweet, and I'll let it rest in the sink. The sink has been washed out. Rinse the knife off. Set it here. Let me get a paper towel out to dry out. Over here we got an ancient grain. There it is. Red quinoa is an ancient grain. I'll even give you a little look here. I'll open it up. Not sure how much you can see. Oh, spilled a couple. But it's a little fine grain. And I'll set it here. Let me get my pot. Seen my ceramic pot, get my measuring cups, and here's what we do. Let's see what we're gonna do today. We're gonna do a quarter cup of quinoa. I'll show you right now. I'll fill this up. And that's a quarter cup is about 180 calories. I don't put a lot of carbs in. And I'll dump it in here, put the cup back, and I'll add about one cup of water right over here. We have our filter on. And I'll show you, here's how simple it is. You can see it has levels of cup and water. And I'll put this on the stove. All right, and over here, we'll put the burner on. We got here in the water. And now we're gonna try to get some vegetables out. Let me put the cups back. Thank you. Gotta watch that cord. All right, this is a butternut squash. I've used it before. I'm going to cut a piece off right now and show you what I do. It's a very nice squash. I'm going to bake it in the oven. Cut the end off. We'll toss it. Split it in half. And I'm just trying to inspire you. I'm not the best cutter with a knife, but I cut it not real thin, about a half an inch or so. Put that there, get the other side, and I use a lot of vegetables, but I may set a couple to the side because this will keep for another meal, and I like my veggies. We'll set this over here. We'll get a tray for it. Let me wash off a zucchini. All right, wipe it down. I cut the end off here where they grew it from the vine, chop that off, pitch it, cut the end, flip it around. Very easy, folks. Just have some fun with this. And I measure it up again, about half inch. go. Put these to the side, get them ready. Then I have these yellow squash are quite large. So I'm only going to use a little bit of it. I'll rinse it off. Better get another paper towel. Dry it and wipe it. There we go. And I'll cut the end off just for where the vine was. Nice, easy, simple cut. Lose a little bit of the veggie, but we'll start cutting. And I'm only going to cut a couple inches. All right, that'll do it there. You can see the collection I have. We'll set this to the side, and I have a couple more surprises for you. As you know, I like my veggies. Just happen to have some asparagus. And we'll take the rubber band off of it. Little struggle. Set that there. And you want them when they're thin. Like these were nice because they're thin. They have a better flavor. These are very fresh. And they're good for you. I'll show you what I do. Again, we rinse everything off. These we can shake dry. And we'll put it here to do a little. I cut about an inch, maybe 2 inches off the edge. That way they don't get stringy for me and they cook up very nice. You can see we're adding these veggies. Brussels sprouts are the next veggie. I cut the little edge off and then I peel the outer leaf off. That way I get a better flavor from it, because these longer leaves don't really have that much flavor and I like the taste. And I'll do about 6 of them. I cut them right in half because I'm going to bake these. Next one we just keep chopping. Watch our fingers. Peel the leaves off right in the garbage I have here. Just taking these leaves off. See, they even come off like they're supposed to be off. Look at that. All right, and we'll cut this. Got my secret tray right here. Spray it down with some virgin olive oil. It's a non-stick, but this helps give a little flavor. We'll just spray it all around. Okay. Mahi Mahi is back out. Set it up there. And we'll start getting these veggies. And I just line them up 3 to a row here. And we'll try the zucchini. Just real nice and easy. Put the bigger ones up here just to get them out of the way. Now we got some of the smaller ones. There we go. And we got some butternut squash. One more. You might be wondering, how's he going to get this all on there? Move it over a little bit. Brussels sprouts. They fit in there very nicely. And look at that. I got just the room for that. Now this will go into the oven. Put the oven on about 470 degrees. Where am I going with this? Right with the asparagus. Here we go. You see my handful? There we go. Let me get a fork out. Stir a little bit of the quinoa. Coming along nicely. We'll get a plate. Got my clear plates. Let's get some water for the green tea. Rinse it out, fill it up. And instead of using my teapot, I moved that away on this show. We just put it in for a minute and it warms up the water. You don't want to boil the water for green tea. And we'll wait there. I'm going to use Young Hyson. This is my loose leaf green tea. And I'm going to show you how I fill up a tea ball. So we'll set this, get ready. All right, let's move this right here. All clear. Little rinse or almost. Throw out the plastic for the Mahi Mahi. Couple little things there. A little bit of paper. Get that off of there. And we're just about ready. Five more seconds. Notice the tea isn't boiling. It's just before it's boiling, so no bubbles and boiling. And we're gonna show you what we do. Let me get a teaspoon out. Nice clean teaspoon. Open up the tea ball. Has a little safety latch here that closes it. Pull that open. Move the knife out of the way. I'll open it up for the camera and you guys to see. This is how simple it is with green tea. Tilt it. One teaspoon of loose leaf green tea. Dropped a couple of the, and I'll just show you. They're like little beadlets here and they open up. And that's loose leaf green tea, Young Hyson. I get it at Nicholas Coffee and Tea in Market Square, downtown Pittsburgh. All right, we'll put a couple more of these in here. I like my tea. All right, we're ready to roll. Seal it back up. Say hi to the penguin. And we put it in. We plop it in. Let it steep for a couple minutes. So watch that timer. Two more minutes on that. I'll put this back. And here's some of my other teas. If you want to get a shot, Lung Ching fourth grade. It actually has a longer leaf. China gunpowder. It's more of a beaded type thing that opens up. And my newest collection from Republic of Tea, blueberry superfruit with loose leaf green tea. Just got that. I don't know if I can give you a little view of it. Not sure how close. Has a little longer leaf there. Has a nice blueberry smell to it, which I wanted to try that. So I experiment with my green teas. Watch this asparagus going along pretty good. Let me taste a little of that quinoa. Still needs a little more cooking there. Let me get a napkin out for later. All right, we got a napkin for later. Set the green tea here. And you can see the water starting to turn a little greenish tint. I'm gonna rinse this off my cutting board. set that right there. All right, we got all this paper from the garlic. Then I got some, got some new ginger. I'll show this to you. As you've seen the show, or if you haven't, I grate up fresh ginger over my whole meal. There's the ginger. There's the package. We'll put it back, and I'll get my shredder out. Handy shredder that I got years ago. Set this on the side, and we'll shred it up here when the meal's just about done. All right, we got our green tea. Let me get a little plate for this because I present it on the table with my plate. Anthony's here filming, doing a good job. But when we end this, Anthony, we'll need the table for the final shot of the meal. Just so you know, coming attractions. I didn't tell you about that. All right, let's see what we got here. The garlic's cooking up very well. Same with the asparagus. Things are moving right on. Let me see about my silicone gloves, protect your hands. And I got to get my thermometer out. As I've told you, my daughter got me one of the best things ever, my thermometer. I need a temperature of about 145. So we'll get this ready. Just get it ready. And we'll see how we are here with the temperature. I'll let you pull in on that. If you can see the thermometer, it's only about 87, 88, 89 degrees. I'm going to flip that over and we'll try to cook some more there. We need it up to 145, so let's see what we can get here. And everything looks like it's cooking very well. Little battle there. We got it. I think that'll do it for the asparagus and garlic. We're getting close. Let's see, check here, may need the knife, put the garlic back up on the shelf up here. Whoa, piece of paper from garlic got there, crazy. All right, we'll save this. Just happen to have a container, looks like a perfect fit. Put that in the refrigerator for another day. Whoop. What happened here? All right, we're good. Put it in the fridge. Whoop. Let's see how we're doing on that timer there. About 22 minutes there. Seems like it's taken a few minutes longer than I thought. So that oven is a little funny there. So we'll try to put up with it. I'll check back in a few minutes. Red quinoa is going away. We don't need it anymore. olive oil out. We put rainbow peppercorns on everything also, like a little seasoning. Gives a good flavor. And my Simply Nature extra virgin olive oil. We'll sprinkle that on there and drizzle it. So we'll see what happens there. Looks like we dropped something here. A little green tea. All right, the penguin's ready. I gotta sip some tea. Delicious. All right, another minute. Quinoa should be good. Yeah, it's turning out very nice. Yep, very good. Well, let's go, let's put the quinoa on the plate. I just scoop it out, have a little strainer there. And this is an ancient grain, like I said. It's been around for thousands of years. Just smooth it out there. Let's see, I have a spoon. Get some more on this plate. Just get it all out. I like to spread it and present it right under the fish. Don't mind if I eat a little, thank you. We'll rinse it out. I like to clean up as I go. And that way you can enjoy your meal and not have to worry about cleaning up. Right, that's dried off. Put this under here and we'll be ready. All right, let's check on that fish again. We may need a couple more minutes, but I'm not sure. Let's find out with that thermometer. It's a little hot. All right. Nope, we still got to go some more, so we need a couple more minutes. Speedy Gourmet is not that speedy today. The electric oven, for some reason, is a little weaker today. And they are finicky. I don't care what people say. I've had limited success with this. Let me rinse it out. Right. Okay, we'll present. I just grab the asparagus and it's nice and warm. Take the rubber band off. You don't want to eat this. Keep this away from children. So I'll present the asparagus over here and the garlic will come out in a bit. You can put this back in a drawer. And the mahi-mahi is a nice, white, sweet fish tasting. It doesn't taste real fishy, and it's similar to swordfish, and it's actually healthy for you. And I only eat fish twice a week because you got to watch with mercury and lead in it. So for all of you that are worried about our health, that's part of it. Ooh. All right, I don't know if we're going to be ready or not, but we're getting close to our time. I'm going to set it right here. I don't know what we'll see here. Oh, we still need 20 more degrees. So we're struggling on a Speedy Gourmet today, folks. I need another little sip of green tea. And then you can just store the butternut squash in your refrigerator. It can last for at least a month, 6 weeks. So I don't do much with it. I just put it in there. And it's very healthy and good for you. Oh, I got some 99-cent Chambersburg peaches. You know how famous they are. So we'll have that for dessert. Had it for a few days. Got it at Fresh Thyme. That's where I got my vegetables from, Fresh Thyme. They have some good prices. These were 99 cents a pound, so it helps out. All right, we're a little bit at a standstill, folks. I could tell you a fishing story, but I never fished for Mahi Mahi. And they got the name Mahi Mahi from Hawaii. And like I said, it's called a dolphin fish, and it's a very tasty, good fish, like I explained. So can't wait to get into it. Let's see what's going on with this oven. One more try. All right. $138, $140, $142, $144. There, look, can you get a close-up on there? We hit it. That last try did it, folks. All right, we'll put the fish right there. We'll get some of the zucchini. Butternut squash. Yellow squash, Brussels sprouts, some garlic, all right, there we go, let's get some ginger, we just start scraping it, shredding it, on the whole meal. As you can see, front and back. Get it off the back. Tap it a little bit. All right, we're done with that. Rainbow peppercorn, one of my faves. Drizzle a little olive oil. Start with the fish, veggies, a little bit there. All right, that's it for the meal. All right, folks, here it is. It was a little bit of overtime, 32 minutes, a new record for the Speedy Gourmet. That electric oven is my excuse. Look at that, nice presentation, very healthy. Even have the penguin, loose leaf green tea. Hope you enjoyed the show. Please stay tuned, and we'll see you again next month. I'll have another fish for you.